Students, welcome to the video lecture series of indirect taxation. Today we are going to solve problems on GST liability, that is module first problem. The problem is like this. You can refer the slide for the problem. From the following details pertaining to Ashwathama, a registered dealer engaged in purchase and sale of goods, ascertain GST liability, that is SGST, state GST, then central GST and integrated GST for the month of September 2019, particulars and amount. In the particulars column, sale price charged to customers within the state, that is excluding GST, they have given 12,50,000. Commission charged to buyers 12,000, packing and forwarding expenses incidental to sale 18,000, weighment charges shown separately in the invoices, that is 9,500, prompt payment discount indicated in invoice 1%, if payment is made within 1 month and all buyers of goods have availed the discount. So the rates of taxes for the goods supplied are as under: CGST 9%, SGST 9% and IGST 18%. So in the problem, what they have given is sale price charged to customers, that is 12,50,000, commission charged to buyers we need to add, then packing and forwarding expenses we need to add, then weighment charges we need to add. So why we need to add? We have to refer the note. As per the section of CGST Act of 2017, all incidental expenses like commission, packing and forwarding, weighment charges form part of the taxable supply. So determination of liability of Ashwathama for the month of September 2019. Make particulars and amount column. So first one, sale price charged to customers within the state. Sale price charged to customers within state. Amount is, excluding GST they have given, that is 12,50,000. Add commission charged to buyers, given in the problem, that is 12,000. You can see the note for this. Next, packing, add packing and forwarding expenses. expenses, expenses incidental to sale. To sale, we can refer note 1. That is 18,000. And weighment charges shown separately in invoices that is note 1. So total 9500. You need to add these values. So once again I'll explain. Sale price charged to customers within the state, that is 12,50,000. Then add commission charged to buyers, packing and forwarding expenses incidental to sales, then weighment charges shown separately in the invoices. All these three particulars you need to add to the sale price. You'll be getting the answer as 12,89,500. So next, what they asked is prompt payment discount they made indicated in the invoice, that is 1%. You need to deduct that amount less prompt payment discount indicated in invoice, that is 1%. See, note 2 says that prompt payment discount is deductible in tax invoice if payment is being made before or at the time of supply. However, if the payment is made post supply, that means after the supply, the amount of discount along with the tax paid thereon can be adjusted by the way of credit note. So here in this case, it is assumed that all buyers paid whole of the amount before the supply is made. So in the event of buyers making the payment post the date of supply, but within 1 month they have mentioned, that is amount is on 12,50,000 is the total sale price, on that 1% we need to deduct. So 1% amount is 12,500 we need to deduct. So if we deduct value of taxable supply, becomes 12,77,000 is the value of taxable supply. On this value of taxable supply, you need to apply SGST at 9% and CGST at 9%. So SGST at 9%. 9% of 12,77,000 is 1,14,930. Next, CGST at 9%. CGST at 9% is equal to 1,14,930. So the total GST payable is, I'll write here. So total GST payable, SGST plus CGST, which was given in the problem. SGST 9%, CGST 9% they have given. We need to add that amount. We will get the answer as 1,14,930 plus 1,14,930, 2,14,930. 29,860. So value of taxable supply becomes 12,77,000 and SGST is 9%, that is 1,14,930, and CGST is 9%, that is 1,14,930. The total answer is GST payable, that is SGST and CGST, we will add that amount, 2,29,860 is the answer.